Chapter 77, the header. Satan perpetuates peace and replaces war with circular learning of the sciences and technology. The father gives Lucifer a chance to repent and forsake his plan for his children. 1. And now, Satan shall begin to see that the cause of all the wars among the children of men shall be the means of their destruction. 2. And when we are witnessing the plan of Lucifer unfold before us, both in the spirit world by those who are dead, and by those of us who are experiencing the effects of the plan of Lucifer still in mortality, we shall begin to see that his plan doth nothing more than cause great turmoil and wars and rumors of war throughout the whole earth. 3. And Lucifer shall begin to realize that his plan is failing to bring forth the fruits that he had promised those who followed him away from the plan of the Father. 4. And now, I will include herein some of the words of the brother of Jared concerning that which he saw in the vision, concerning the time that Lucifer shall begin to realize that his plan is not succeeding as he had intended for it to succeed in the beginning. 5. And I saw in the Spirit of the Lord Lucifer stand up before those who followed him in the realm of the spirits, where they are kept locked in prison of their own accord, and unable to take upon them the second estate that would be necessary for their progression in the eternal worlds of the Father. 6. And there were many of these spirits who complained to Lucifer that that which was promised by him was not giving to them the happiness that they desired, even the happiness and joy that he had promised them. 7. And Lucifer cursed the earth and sent forth a command to all of those who followed him that they should stop their wars for a time and bring to pass the things that would bring temporary happiness to the people. 8. And among all the great nations and kingdoms that were set up, the wars did stop for a time, and Satan went to and fro upon the earth giving inspiration and revelation to the children of men concerning their plights as mortals. 9. And there were schools of thought set up among them, and great institutions of learning and practice that enabled them to bring more of the promise of Satan to fruition, that they might begin to enjoy their lives in mortality. 10. And the people began to seek out the knowledge that would ease their lives of the burdens that had been placed upon them by the works of their leaders. 11. And the leaders of the nations began to send forth explorers and scientists to solve the mysteries that nature presented to them. And a period of time known as the Great Renaissance came forth upon the earth, giving to the children of men a great sense of themselves and their own natures. 12. And once Satan had influenced the people to think in the manner that he would have them think, he led them down any path that they would follow in search for the meaning of life and for the happiness for which their souls craved. 13. And it came to pass that there arose out of this time many wise and talented men, as far as the arm of the flesh is concerned, or as far as the knowledge of man is given unto them. 14. And Satan continued to have great power over the hearts and minds of men, even as he was giving them peace for a time. 15. But Lucifer was dissatisfied with the way in which his plan was unfolding upon the earth, because he was still prohibited from revealing unto men the great powers of nature that were a prerequisite to understanding the great powers that the Father possesseth. 16. And Lucifer complained to the Father that in order for his plan to take its full effect, he needed to be able to give to the earth a portion of the power of a God, so that he could show the other spirit children of the Father the full effect of the happiness that they would receive from following him as their God. 17. And he spoke in the Spirit unto the Father, saying, O, Father, until this time have I been forbidden by thee to show forth a portion of thy power unto those of us who would have all thy children possess the power of the gods. 18. And thou knowest that the end is near, as thou hast set the order of all things for us. How then, O Father, can I prove the worthiness of my plan, unless thou releasest me and allowest me to give unto the earth the beginnings of thy power, that they might know the righteousness of that which I have proposed before them? 19. And I know that thou art a fair God, but I also know that when the last time cometh, that thou shalt send forth thy spirit unto the earth to influence the children of men, it shall be the end of time. And there shall be no more time given unto me to exercise the ability to show forth the righteousness of my plan, without the interference of thy spirit. 20. Therefore, O Father, in all fairness before the laws of heaven, I ask of thee that I be released from these bonds, and be allowed to introduce thy power upon the earth, so that I might prove my words therein. 21. And I saw the Father call forth Lucifer from the spirit world into his own kingdom to answer his prayer. 22. And Lucifer stood before the Father, and the Father took Lucifer by himself and said unto him, My son, that which thou hast done in the world which I have caused to be created for my children hath proven that thy plan cannot work to the benefit of the happiness of all of my children. 23. And is not the fruit of thy works proof enough unto thee, that the eternal plan which I have given unto all of my children is the only plan that can provide them eternal happiness? 24. Please, my son, go to those that follow after thee, and have them return unto me, and follow the plan that I have set before you, and ye shall all be saved in my kingdom. For behold, I will give unto you this chance to repent of your misdoings, and once again accept the eternal laws of heaven. 25. Nevertheless, my son, because of the eternal laws of heaven that govern me, thou art forbidden forever from having a celestial body, and partaking of its power and glory, because of the things which thou hast desired for thine own glory and happiness. 26. And when Lucifer heard these things, he turned away from the Father, and demanded of the Father that he be allowed to do what had been done in other worlds, and that he be allowed to prove his plan to those that followed him. 27. And the Father wept for Lucifer, but commanded his angels to give unto him that which he desired, to help him for the last time to make an attempt to prove the worthiness of his plan. 28. And the Father did this so that none of his children could ever proclaim that Lucifer was not given every opportunity available to use his free agency to create the happiness that he desired according to his own plan. 29. And now, I, Moroni, have given you the time period of the time, and times, and half of time. And it was at the beginning of the half of time that the Father released Lucifer to allow him to introduce to the world many of the mysteries of nature that would be necessary for the children of men to understand so that they could begin to use the power of God among them. 30. And it was just before this time, even at the very end of the times, that the full effect and greatness of science and technology was first introduced to the children of men. 31. And I have seen your day, and have the words of the brother of Jared before me. And I have been instructed at this time in this record to reveal unto you in plainness many of the mysteries of nature that Satan was forbidden to give unto you in past generations of the children of men. 32. And the greatest mystery among you, even that mystery which shall be the cause of much turmoil and misery among you, is the mystery of the power of electricity, as it is known among you, even a great power of nature that shall be used in the latter days to deceive the people of the earth, and turn all of the children of men away from the plan of the Father. 33. And before Lucifer was released to give this knowledge unto the world, he began, during this time that the brother of Jared hath written as the time of the Renaissance, to influence the minds of some men in that which he could reveal unto them of science, and of the knowledge that would lead them to the revelations that they would eventually receive when he was released from the restrictions that were placed upon him by the Father. 34. And there were many men who made great strides in the introduction of these things of Satan. 35. And now, these same men have become renowned and great in the eyes of all other men in the latter days who have benefited from their works. 36. And I have seen some of their names in the words of the brother of Jared. Nevertheless, I will not include their names in this record, because they are servants of Satan, and deserve no more honor for that which they have done, except that which hath already been given unto them by Satan and those who follow him. 37. And now, ye of the latter days should know why these men are considered servants of Satan, when they are instrumental in bringing forth the truth of the power of God. 38. Behold, all of the holy prophets knew of the great power of electricity, and the power that was held in nature to create many miracles among the children of men. Yea, these holy men saw all of the great advancements of the plan of Lucifer in the latter days. 39. Yea, they saw the extraordinary and seemingly miraculous means of transportation that ye have among you, even by ground and by air and by sea, even up into the heavens beyond the boundaries of this earth. 40. Yea, they saw the miraculous means by which ye communicate and speak one to another, and the ease of your lives in so many ways. 41. Yea, they saw your attempts to colonize the planets and make them into the kingdoms of men, without the aid of the Father. 42. In fine, they saw all the miracles of science and technology that the Father hath allowed Satan to give unto you in the latter days. 43. And these are the things that they were forbidden to speak of, and of which they could not write. For behold, they knew how these things would affect the minds and hearts of the children of men, and that they would create great wickedness and misery among them. 44. But even more, they knew that as soon as these things are introduced unto the children of men, there should only be a short time until they take the power of these things and use them to destroy themselves and turn their hearts completely away from the purpose of the plan of the Father. 45. And for this same reason have all the holy prophets testified of the great wickedness that would be upon the earth in the latter days before the great and dreadful day of the Lord. 46. And now, ye of the latter days have seen that the words of the prophets are true concerning these things. For ye know that the cause of your misery and the degradation of the natural health of the earth is caused by the misuse of this power that hath been given unto you. 47. And ye have harnessed even greater power than that which electricity hath given unto you. For ye have developed nuclear power, which is a power much greater than the power of electricity. 48. And ye shall also discover that there is still an even greater power that ye have among you. But the knowledge of this greater power that shall be given unto you shall be restricted in its use by the Lord. 49. For if ye understood the fullness in the way in which this power is used by the gods, then ye would use it to destroy the earth in one day. 50. For by this power was the great sun created that giveth light unto the world. But the Father hath limited the ability of Satan to give unto you this greater power, so that ye might not destroy yourselves before the Lord is able to once again establish peace upon the earth and reign among you for 1,000 years, showing forth the plan of the Father for the last time without the influence of Satan against you. 51. And during this 1,000 years of peace, this greater power shall be used to heal the earth and bring things to the earth that have never been known by the children of men. End of chapter 77.